San Carlos Malo. That's not that though. Here is Indian Root. It's a traditional remedy for spider bites that refuse to heal. Used only in small doses, it stimulates production of white blood cells for treatment of colds. As a bitter digestive stimulant, it relieves stomach cramps and intestinal blockages. The powdered root can be applied topically to abrasions and infected slow healing sores. There it is. That's not it there. I wonder if that's it. Anyways, this is just to stimulate you folks to get out here on your own. And Hartman's Sumac family, Northern Sonora. I've seen these. Desert Willow. It's an antifungal taken internally to inhibit the excessive growth of Candida albicans, a yeast infection that causes digestive odors, hemorrhoids, with extensive use of antibiotics and anti-inflammatories. Powdered leaves and twigs are topically antiseptic when applied to cuts and abrasions. In Sonora, the elegant flowers, that's them, are used as a tea and hot poultice for hectic coughing with sore lungs and for heart weakness. Wow. Good thing I learned that. This is a pineapple family down here. Now that's this little plant under here. Looks like an agave, but it says it isn't. Hectia montana. And of course, we have the jojoba. Semenacea chinensis, jojoba family. That's this plant. A lot of oil is extracted from those. This is your Mormon tea, Ephedra aspera, Ephedra family, native. I love this stuff. Snakeweed, traditional snake bite medicine, but is best known as a soothing remedy for the pain of arthritis. Mild in between. It also relieves stomach aches and can be drunk, sometimes aided with an abdominal poultice to reduce uterine swelling after childbirth. And that's this plant. Snakeweed, Deuterius californicus. Composites, a member of the sunflower. It's called a desert hop bush. Soapberry family. Dodonaria viscosus. Yep. Still walking up through this Sonoran. Sweet acacia. The pods, leaves, flowers, and mucilaginous root of sweet acacia are astringent and anti-inflammatory. A tea is made from sweet acacia for sore throats, mouth, stomach inflammations, vomiting, diarrhea, and dysentery. Externally, the tea or powdered disinfect wound helps stop superficial bleeding, soothe sores, ulcers, and skin inflammation such as diaper rash and chapped skin. That's this little tree. Palmeri, agave palmeri. Palo Adin, Ocotillo family. That's the little cactus in there. I don't see a agave parva flora. Shot agave, Scotia, agave family. Foothills, Palo Verde, a legume family. Well, let's see what they have to say about Mormon tea. The leafless twigs of Mormon tea are simmered to make a pleasant drinking and mildly stimulating drink used by sellers as a substitute for black coffee. Its primary use has been to relieve mild kidney and urinary tract infections. Mormon tea contains small amounts of ephedrine, making it an effective remedy for hay fever, allergies, and spasmodic coughing. One series native to China contains large amounts of ephedrine and is used in the drug industries. Well, there you have it, ephedrine. Yeah, I know I'm next to the highway, folks. We'll be getting out of that soon. And the jojoba. Teas made from the leaves is an anti-inflammatory astringent used by Mexican healers to treat asthma, emphysema, tonsillitis, and pharyngitis. In general, it's used for any chronic mucous membrane inflammation. They're rich in an emollient oil used in the manufacture of hair and skin products. It's a high-temperature, high-pressure industrial lubricant. It's an important browse plant. So I guess a lot of sheep and all and animals eat that. A lot of these. Here's a nice palmer here. This is a large palmer agave. This one really came out nice. Some things look dead, some don't. This is called the Boyce Thompson Hedgehog. Echinocereus Boyce Thompson, a cactus family. How about that? And this is called the Little Leaf Palo Verde. There's a pair of tarantula hawks. Oh, here it is, flat top buckwheat. That's this flower. I've always wanted to know what that was. The whole plant of flat top buckwheat is dried and made into astringent tea for cuts, wounds, and eye wash, a wash for newborns, a gargle, and a douche. Wow. How nice is this? Pencil choy. Desert thorn. Well, I'm going to turn around or go back down here, folks. Really high up under. There's even a Ramada up here. Well, desert lavender. Cold tea of the minty and slightly bitter desert lavender. Bee sage can soothe the nausea of hangover and stomach flu. As a hemostatic astringent, it helps stop bleeding, hemorrhoids, and excessive menstrual bleeding. Topically is used by native peoples in Sonora for toothache and earache. Huh. I wonder where the plant is. I don't see it. Going through this Ramada, we can look out over the Oh, I see some caves way over there. In that area. Too far to walk. So we're gonna go around, see where this takes us. See you in a minute.